The whole purpose of Shaping the Future was to follow a vision that we started 20 years ago when we had our first conference in 1995, in fact, where our patron was Sir Mark Oliphant, the father of Australian science, who was at Australian National University, who worked with Pugwash, with Eisenberg and Einstein, and who was the governor of South Australia. And he really was devoted to peace for all his life after he walked out of the Manhattan Project, which was designing the atomic bomb, which eventually bombed Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Now, that's just a background to where we are coming from. And since then, we've developed a huge amount of network all around the world. And this is why we've had the privilege of having such wonderful speakers at our Shaping the Future conference between August the 15th and 17th. Now, the whole purpose is to see that everything is integrated. You cannot have health, happiness, well-being, sustainability, cooperation and coordination within people, within systems, within the essence of the body, without there being change in our fundamental way of life. The system is, in fact, stuffed. There's no way that we can deal with the system as it stands. We have to throw away the system and start a new system. Your lack of active participation in politics does not exempt you for the responsibility for the results. What it means is that the politicians who are our leaders, in fact, are leading us into disarray and degradation and destruction. And there is no time left, which means that we have to take action now. Even in 1992, the World Scientists' Warning to Humanity, signed by 1,600 leading scientists, including half of all Nobel Prize winners, representing 71 countries, said that no more than a few decades remain, we, the undersigned senior members of the world's scientific community, hereby warn all of humanity of all what lies ahead. Great change in our stewardship of the earth and life on it is required if vast human misery is to be avoided and our global home on this planet is not to be irretrievably mutilated. We are encumbered by failing human systems, by hunger and chronic disease, by phase extinction of all living beings, by inhumanity, by wars, by species out of control, whereby we have 7 billion people, where most of them are going to be in large cities and slums, where they're going to be compromised in terms of their resources. Half of all those people currently exist on less than $2.5 a day. So humanity has barely moved out of its basic physiological needs. And most of the world are fighting for survival. Most of the world don't want to fight survival. Most of the purple people want some kind of change. They want some respect for their lives and their well-being and their nature, their true nature. So Shaping the Future looks at and expresses the dignity of the human psyche, the value and sacredness of each human life. And the fact is that we cannot keep on having interminable wars and look to our leaders to try and lead us to a sustainable path. Because they're not. All they're concerned about is short-term goals. Or they don't look at the long-term, they look at future generations. They're concerned about economic needs. We're digitalized and compartmentalized and looked at as collateral damage. We're not looking at the basic needs of humanity, which are much more than that. They're based on values and ethics and safety needs and self-actualization. So I'll finish by just quoting from Leo Tolstoy in War and Peace, who says that the highest wisdom has but one science, the science of the whole, the science explaining the whole creation and man's placement. And that is what the ongoing Shaping the Future is about, including the ongoing forums. So please join us in our forums, in our roundtables. Thank you.